Okay, time to pull these babies off. Do a final temperature check, but I already know that they're, well, it's 85.6 degrees out. And it's almost midnight here, July 31st, 2016. Look at that sizzle. Nice color. Johnsonville sweet Italian sausages. Man, these are good. Some buns in the house. I got some Sargento deli sliced cheese. I'm gonna throw a little cheddar on there. Let's get that temperature. 165 is, according to the USDA, says they're done. Those are 202 or whatever. They're plenty done. But these digital thermometers, they fluctuate. And this is cast iron. So I always lowball it about by 20 degrees. Boy, look at that. You can just see the juice is just pouring out of these babies. Just love the Johnsonville, man. These are so good. Look at that juice, man. Don't want to overcook them, as these will dry out on you if you do overcook them. Nice. Give them a little final wrap there. And then what you do is you let them rest. Most important thing, your amateurs and greenhorns make the mistake. You gotta let them rest for a good 5-6 minutes. If you don't, and you cut into it, all the juices are gonna run out. You want all those juices, all this protein molecules to reconstitute themselves and combine it in a beautiful way. It's called barbecue science, and there really is a science to it. Your steak, go to a restaurant, buy an expensive steak. The chefs know, man, when you get a steak, if you ever cooked went to a 4th of July party or a barbecue at a friend's house, and a steak comes off the grill and you cut right into it with the steak knife, what happens? All the juices run out right onto the plate. Nope, you gotta let meat rest, man. There really is a science to it, and it's very important. All your true barbecue pit masters know this. Okay, there it is, Yellow Groove. Rub-a-dub-dub, time to grub.